In this video, we will continue with a fox design and create a new variation based, this time, on a vector image. Let's see how it works. Vector images are created by a special software, and the parts of the images are actually represented by mathematical expressions. For example, these sample CMX files, which are provided along with the software, are vector files. For the purpose of this video, we will select this fox image. Once you select the image and open it, it is automatically converted into an embroidery design. The software directly detects the vector parts and automatically applies stitches. Starting from a vector image, you can create an embroidery design in just a few clicks. Now, let's create another version of this fox design. As already mentioned, it is always a good practice to review the shape of the artwork using Node Editor and fine-tune the shape if you need to. We will apply satin fill to try to imitate a satin look. Satin fill is not suitable for such wide areas, as the stitches may break or the needle may catch a previous thread and mess the whole thing. Satin fill has thread penetration points only at the edges of the shape. So, to make a satin look possible in this case, we will apply a pattern. When applying a pattern, the satin look is achieved because stitches are added within the shape so that it is properly stabilized. For a satin part like that, the next step would be to add direction and divides to enhance the flow of the stitches. Apply a couple different directions on the tail for a more natural look of the fur, and a couple of divides for a 3D look. Now, the head may look strange, so let's add a divide here. And try adding some directions. Or even try a point direction if you like. Likewise, you can add point directions on the eyes and ears. You can also change the direction of the tip of the tail to make it more pointy as it should be. You can go on editing a couple of stitches here and there to achieve an as natural look as you like. Have fun experimenting